Christian Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Teatime Discipleship for Mothers and Daughters, Pouring Faith, Love, and Beauty into Your Girl's Heart by Sally Clarkson. Narrated by Sally Clarkson. To my children, Sarah, Joy, and Kelia, Clay, Joel, Nathan, you are my most delightful teatime companions. Your lives have added so much beauty to mine. Your words inspire, your antics delight, your faith enlarges my own view of God. Let's have a million more cups and transform our world together. To my lovely granddaughters, Lillian and Lucy, I hope to share many inspiring and delightful tea times in our years together. Special thanks to Kelia Clarkson, my beloved daughter-in-law, for her excellent help in crafting some of our family stories and traditions into life-giving words. And to Jackie, my dear tea angel. By wisdom a house is built, and through understanding it is established. Through knowledge its rooms are filled with rare and beautiful treasures. Proverbs chapter 24, verses 3 through 4. Tasting the fruit of discipleship, intro. Students are not greater than their teacher, but the student who is fully trained will become like the teacher. Luke chapter 6, verse 40. Early one morning, I brewed my tea, lit a candle, turned on my favorite playlist, and sat to breathe in some peace before my day began. As usual, I had piles on my heart and mind and needed to center myself to prepare for a busy day. Before I work or settle in for a quiet moment with my tea, I turn off all digital notifications except those coming from my kids. So when I heard the ping announcing a new email, I opened it right away. Dear Mama, I was thinking about you today. It seems every place I go, all the places I have lived, I hear your voice speaking to me. The hundreds of books we read out loud remind me of the heroines I want to become. The countless morning devotions speak to me through verses we discussed and memorized. The intimate talks on the front porch, reserved just for me and you over a snack, remind me that I am loved and cared for. Basically, you are a part of my being every day, and the messages you took time to share guide me wherever I go. I just didn't know if I had ever thanked you for taking the time, Mama. I appreciate all you did to shape great souls inside of us, and I love you so very much. That's all. Just wanted you to know. Love, a Clarkson child. Of course, this note brought happy tears to my eyes and delighted my mother heart. So often we sow into our children through love, teaching, serving, and giving our time endlessly. Yet we aren't always sure if the seeds we planted are ever going to grow and bear fruit. I read this note a second time, and a rush of memories flooded my mind. Memories of the many women who showed me the value of discipleship and how to disciple other women and my children. This child of mine would not have had an example or experience for which to thank me had I not received those examples and experience in my journey. That's why I wrote this book. I want to continue the legacy by sharing with you how parenting discipleship unfolded in my life and providing simple and meaningful discipling moments for you to share with your daughter. If you know me at all, you will not be one bit surprised that I have chosen tea time as the backdrop for these special times. Life is just sweeter when a hot pot of tea and a lovely talk of faith are shared between two hearts. Though I wrote this book with mothers and daughters in mind, I have mentored my wonderful boys similarly. Time stolen to be alone with tea and treats and talks. We followed the example of Tolkien and Lewis, So know that tea time is a great place to shape the hearts of our beloved boys as well. Modeling our faith becomes mentoring a heart when we consistently pour into our child by talking openly, listening intently, praying together, and steeping in Scripture side by side. Whether you've been discipling others for years, or this is your invitation to serve God in this way, you will find there is nothing more meaningful or fruitful than discipling your kids and seeing what God does when your story and your child's story are explored in God's big, beautiful story. How joyful are those who fear the Lord, all who follow His ways. You will enjoy the fruit of your labor. Your children will be like vigorous young olive trees as they sit around your table. That is the Lord's blessing for those who fear Him. Psalm 128, verses 1 through 4. When God calls you. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me. John chapter 10, verse 27. Bone-chilling fog wafted through the mysterious ancient cobblestone streets as I made my way to school each morning in Krakow, Poland. Mists wrapped around gray stone walls of the aged city, whispering of the hidden secrets of kings and queens who resided there through hundreds of years. Living there during the communist occupation meant we could not buy much food, meat was scarce, and fresh fruit and vegetables were rare and brought into small open-air markets only in season. But always we could find beautifully carved wooden boxes of every size, shape, and style. Hoping that someday I would have my own cottage to fill with beauty and color, I would scan the hundreds of choices to find a distinctly crafted box that might someday find a place in my imagined future home. I was particularly drawn to the treasure chests that had keys to lock away precious letters, secrets, journals, or jewels. Years later, when my home became a reality and little feet pattered around, my treasure chests became favorite relics in my home. Often, I would hide a verse scribbled on a piece of colored paper, some gold-covered chocolate coins, a tiny ring or bracelet, a knight in shining armor, or a small puzzle inside these boxes for my children to discover. Glee and intrigue would fill their hopeful little eyes as they opened the chest to see what was inside. During a quiet time one morning, my eyes lighted upon one of my little chests, and the Holy Spirit impressed me to look at the hearts of my children as treasure chests, filling their hearts with truth, beauty, love, great thoughts, books, ideas, adventures, memories, traditions, wisdom, music, art, lessons, and all the good things I could imagine became a purposeful goal. I wanted to fill them with such an abundance of relics of eternal value that they would draw beauty, strength, guidance, assurance, courage, and love from those deposits for the rest of their lives. God was clearly calling me to disciple my children, and just as my digital settings make sure I always hear messages from my kids, my spiritual settings make sure I always hear and answer a call from God. I was excited and committed. I realized, though, that I could not give them what I did not myself possess. If I wanted the souls of my children to be rich, then my soul needed to be rich because it was my soul they would draw from. And so the idea of intentionality began to engage the imagination of my heart. Whatever I filled my mind with, whatever I learned and embraced, flowed into the well of knowledge and refreshment I would draw from and pass on to them daily as I lived my moments in their presence. For example, investing time every morning with the Lord was of utmost importance because what I learned in those moments shaped the passion I passed to my family each morning over breakfast. First, there is a foundation. I have been blessed by excellent women sprinkled along my life path who have invested deeply in my emotional and spiritual health. I never could have written books, had a national and local ministry, finished the course as an intentional mother in my home, and stayed faithful to my marriage without the help, support, comfort, and strength I received from other women. Differing in age, personality, educational background, and life experience, they each added a grace to the treasure chest of wisdom stowed inside my heart. Each has helped me to flourish when otherwise I would have floundered. I began to grow from and appreciate this kind of intentional mentoring as a young woman, and even more so as I started a family. Discipling became a poignant focus of relationship I wanted to pass on to all my children. That day when I envisioned each of my children as a treasure chest to fill with the treasures of God's truth and gems of God's grace, I became excited about parenting in a new way. Influence is best cultivated through love and friendship. So I prayed to deepen my sympathy for what was going on in their hearts at different ages, to understand their personalities, to affirm their intrinsic worth to me and to God and to others, and to encourage them daily. My pursuit as a mother and discipler was to become the most mature and wise woman I could be in my own life, and then, from that place, be an excellent woman reflecting my love for God. I knew it would be challenging for my daughters to find women with biblical ideals, so I wanted to be this example in front of my girls. I'm sure you carry the same concern and desires for your daughter. In response to this burden on my heart, I sought to grow in integrity and graciousness so my girls would have a model for the rest of their lives. I'll admit that my imperfection and immaturity were evident along the journey, yet I gave all my heart and faith and effort into the hands of Jesus and kept going one day after another toward my goals. This, dear mom, is what you can do too. You don't need a teaching degree. You don't need a Master of Divinity. You don't need a ribbon of honor for oratory achievements. All you need as your foundation to begin is a heart for Jesus and for your child. That is how you answer the call to discipleship. A legacy of love. When we set in motion traditions formed by faith and values in action, a legacy of love that begins with Jesus is strengthened in our homes. The day our children notice that we aren't just praying at the dinner table, but in every circumstance, is a moment they tuck away as a guide to and evidence of living a faithful life. Later, when times become difficult for the growing child, or when tensions rise at home, those memories remain, and the lessons experienced through intentional discipling and from our example of living a sincere faith are there as a foundation. Don't ever believe your child isn't noticing how you live and how you interact with them as well as others. They see it all. They make note of our priorities and how we invest our time and resources. And when they realize they are one of those top priorities and you are choosing to pour into them with time, prayer, teaching, and connection, they get a glimpse of God's love and care for them. Parenting through the lens of mentoring and discipleship will inspire, train, and stretch us and our children to live into our God-given potential. When we are given the gift to add to and continue a legacy of God's love shared between women and between generations, we are transformed. I am a different person because of the faithfulness, encouragement, and inspiration I gave to and received from my friends and now my daughters. I remember your genuine faith, for you share the faith that first filled your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice, and I know that same faith continues strong in you. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 5. For such a time as this. Why is it more important than ever to be accountable to our girls, to give them an identity as beautiful women who can think, create, and love as they nurture education, family, and marriage in their homes? It is because the belief in the fullness of biblical femininity has been lost in a sea of the extremes of femininity that are put forth. In this time in history, there is more competition than ever for the soul and brain space of all of us. With smartphones and social media, we are bombarded with messages from a secular culture that challenge our biblical convictions and teach a contrasting morality, a relative set of values. Add to that, the church seems to be filled with leaders and believers who have diminished their stories with compromises of every kind. Who knows but that you have come to your royal position for such a time as this? Esther chapter 4, verse 14. It is more important than ever for our children to deeply feel our love and experience great joy and friendship with us, so they will continue wanting our input and influence in their lives. Parents are created by God to come alongside, to champion, help, and encourage their children to live into their God-designed destinies. Every step toward deepening your relationship with your daughter and her relationship with the Lord is needed for such a time as this, not only in terms of history, but for this season in your daughter's life. And I imagine this meaningful endeavor is for such a time as this in your story, too. By answering God's call to discipleship, you and your daughter will forever be changed. Expressing your love for your daughter and the condition of her heart will do much to encourage her. And sharing these times over tea adds a ritual of sweet connection that won't be lost if things aren't perfect. You should know up front that things won't be perfect, and they will be lovely and rewarding just the same. Even that is a life and faith lesson for your young daughter. The most significant influence comes through an atmosphere of unconditional love, through pleasant experiences shared, through trust and conversation. It's because of the commitments that we cultivate over time and the willingness to be vulnerable and authentic that we bring about support and encouragement, communication and connection, respect and understanding, all the blessings true friendships have in common. Your desire for a deeper friendship with your daughter will be evident in your commitment to spend time with her when the focus isn't on homework or household chores or negotiating technology time. Speaking of which, let's not forget that we're the most connected generation technologically and the most isolated from our neighbors. It requires more effort and forethought and sometimes plain courage and boldness to reach out to others in person. Women in this era have either forgotten the intrinsic potential they have as women sharing in friendship, faith, and community, or they are too distracted, overwhelmed, and busy to access the glory and beauty of their femininity and how it blooms more fully in the context of loving relationships. Many are afraid or reticent to embrace the delight and joy of discipleship as a regular and valued part of their experiences.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.